There is a rumor that it is possible to print edge to edge on a Latex 360. It's true. You can print edge to edge on a Latex 360. When we released the printer, we seriously considered offering borderless or edge to edge printing as a feature on the printer. And we developed it to be able to do that. What we found, though, is because of the variability and just the room for error on too many different media types, that we decided that we weren't going to advocate that. And I think that was rightly chosen. But it doesn't mean that the feature won't work, it's just that it's not officially supported by HP. When we officially support something, we want to test it and vet it through a whole series of different medias. And there's a lot of medias that will run very effectively, borderless or edge to edge, and then there's some medias that are not going to work so well. So let me show you how I sort of approach it, a couple different ways to think about it, and if you want to try edge to edge and you're willing to accept that, you know, some medias will work pretty well and some probably won't, and the fact that you could possibly have a head crash as a result, you can certainly give it a go if you're an intrepid soul. Hopefully, in the worst case scenario, you take out a couple print nozzles. Best case scenario, it works perfectly for you. So let me show you a couple approaches and see what you think. The original approach was used to ink collectors. When you're printing edge to edge, whatever goes outside the material, let's say it's a 36-inch banner, you want to print right to the edge. So you put the ink collectors in, whatever goes outside the banner goes onto the ink collector, and presto, you're good to go. Now keep in mind, you will not be able to use the edge guards. Now, I don't use the edge guards very much anyway, so for most materials it's not going to be an issue. But if you do run a material that might need the edge guards, edge to edge is probably not going to work at all, because you have no edge guards. But with that off, this was the original plan. Now the trouble with that, to some degree, of running with the ink collectors on, is a lot of medias, depending on the media, especially without tension, will try to kind of sag a little bit there, and that can affect your image quality. It can elongate text, other problems. So not all medias are going to run effectively going over the ink collectors. In those cases, you'd have to use the original platens, the flat platen that you normally have in for frontlit media. Here's what I do. I run a flat platen, and then instead of running the flat platen as is, I take a little piece of 2-inch masking tape, just a little piece, and I cut maybe a quarter of an inch, and I put that right where the edge of the media is. So essentially, the piece of tape becomes my ink collector. And then when I'm done, I just peel that off, whatever little residual I clean off with a little bit of alcohol and a clean cotton rag, and I'm good to go. If you were doing really long runs, it might be better to use the ink collector. But a lot of borderless, I just do a short run on borderless, put the little pieces of tape on, take the pieces of tape off, I'm good to go. I like the blue painter's tape because it doesn't leave any adhesive residue and it's easy to get off. Now, obviously, HP's engineering team is not going to create an application where essentially putting small pieces of tape on the platen is a solution for us. That's not what we do. But I'm saying that as a sort of operator, sort of a little workaround, that's a pretty good solution. What I like about it is it still preserves the nice flat platen and almost all of the vacuum holes. And the vacuum on this is thereby very effective. I try to even put the blue tape where it doesn't cover the vacuum holes as possible, because I don't want those edges to be deprived of vacuum. I want vacuum all the way through the material. Now, another thing to keep in mind when you're running edge to edge, you have to go in the rip and tell the rip exactly the size of the media that's on there. So if this material was 36.15 inches, what you do is you go into Onyx and you say, create a new roll. You say, 36.15 inch roll, colon, NM, capital NM. If you look in Onyx, for example, or any of the rips, really, you'll see the NM designation. NM means no margin. Hence, we were planning to do this, we just couldn't get enough media as we thought it might be too many problems. But those NMs are left over from that attempt. So built into Onyx is NM, but it has to be named exactly the size it's on there. So in many cases, it's not just 24 inches, it's 24.125. That's the size of the media. You do colon NM, you'll see the nomenclature. That's what you follow to do borderless or edge-to-edge printing. So hopefully you choose a media that makes sense, something that's stable, and good luck with your borderless printing attempts. Just wanted to give you a little workaround. If you want to try it, give it a go. These are some of the ways that we've been doing it in our demo center.